heated debate ensued during the debate on the preliminary report on sugar.
Speaker, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker.
With lawmakers terming the report as shallow and unsatisfactory, the lawmakers taking issue with the probing team for failing to conclusively say whether the sugar is safe or not and whether importers evaded duty.
So far, from the preliminary laboratory tests and ongoing analysis, no traces of mercury have been found. However, investigations on the same and different samples are going on.
Mr. Speaker, the question as to whether mercury is found in the sugar in the market is not conclusive. Mr. Speaker, under your leadership, we owe our allegiance under the Constitution 95.
What the committee should have asked us, Mr. Speaker, and two of them, was to extend time to investigate beyond the sugar that was presented to them. But Mr. Speaker, listen to the committees. It is just a joke. This report is just a joke of the highest order.
The report by the Joint Committees of Agriculture and Trade, however, says some of the sugar was found to have a high moisture content.
We've moved from mercury to copper to lead, now to moisture. I don't know. We will move to what next?
Alcohol. The figures we are being given are of the sugars that were confiscated. That is totally different from the sugar that is in the shelf.
We are not helping Kenyans. The issue of concern, to under 95-2 is the safety of Kenyans.
What about the sugar that already left the warehouses and came to our shelves, which we are now consuming as Kenyans?
The report, which recommended a ban on bulk importation of sugar, sparking more heated debate as the committee's chairman, Kanini Kega and Aden Haji, pleaded to be heard.
The citizens are in limbo. They don't know what to consume. The importers, Mr. Speaker, people who have put their money in sugar, don't know what is going to happen to the investment. Mr. Speaker, this House cannot take this kind of decision.
There are Kenyans who told us that there is mercury in some sugar. What the committee should have done was to zero in on these people, ask them where that sugar is, which has mercury. If those people are supposed to avail the sugar with mercury, or without mercury, then the committee determines that the sugar that was spoken about does not have mercury.
The samples are ongoing. Every day there is a plethora of samples which are getting into the laboratories of KEBS. And we cannot effectively conclude about the test results which we do not have.
The disappointing report leaving the legislators calling for the dissolution of the committees and an establishment of an ad hoc committee.
There is no need to even give these committees any extra time. This work has defeated them. Let us either rely on other investigative organs or we create an ad hoc committee.
A joint committee used public resources for over 2 weeks, Mr. Speaker. And Mr. Speaker, the kind of recommendation, Mr. Speaker, I'm seeing here, Mr. Speaker, even in some county assemblies, such recommendations are not found.
Unless you are looking for a specific answer, or certainly you have certain interest, it is very, very unfair to even condemn us, saying that this report does not even qualify to be in a county assembly. This is, I think, the leader of majority should actually apologize, or even declare the interest that he has in this, because if we have.
The shallow report was released amid claims that some powerful figures had attempted to influence the committees to write a favorable report. It is back to square one for the National Assembly's Joint Committee that has been probing the contraband sugar in the country, with Speaker of the National Assembly Justin Muturi ordering the Joint Committee to repeat the probe and ensure that it unlocks the truth on the contraband sugar in the country and report back to the House when MPs will be resuming from recess in 2 weeks' time. Stephen Letoo, Citizen TV, Parliament Buildings in the capital, Nairobi.